Scott McCauley Performing Arts Center, we acknowledge that the land upon which we gather is unceded Mi'kmaq territory. Epiquet, Prince Edward Island, is covered by the historic treaties of peace and friendship.
Okay.
We pay our respects to the indigenous Mi'kmaq people who have occupied this land for over 12,000 years, past, present, and future. Thank you, and enjoy the show.
Wow. Thank you very much.
Thank you everyone so much for coming this evening. My name is Brandon Kelly. I'm the instrumental music director here at Three Oaks. And we're so happy to be here playing all of the music we've been working on all semester. We've performed at Band Days, we've performed in Montreal, we even performed at Mount Allison University last week. It's been a semester full of performances, and we're excited to bring it all together into one program today. That first piece you heard, Age of Chivalry, was written by Ryan Niebuhr. He's a Canadian composer. Actually went to school at the University of Toronto, which is where I went to for 2 years. And little did I know that he's actually a band teacher. Kind of crazy. So he's doing everything that I do, except he's also writing music like this. So pretty impressive. That one is inspired by the medieval knights of way back when. And the idea with us is we wanted to demonstrate the theme of nobility, honor, and strength. I'm out of a little breath after that one. That's good. Really well done, guys. I'm going to sit back in terms of the talking tonight. The students are going to be introducing the pieces. I'll talk a little bit later. But we hope you enjoy this program. There's lots of variety in this program tonight. And we're going to kick it off with an orchestral arrangement, or a wind arrangement of an orchestral work. And I'm going to let Emma do the talking.
Hi, my name is Emma McMahon, and I'm a grade 11 student in the clarinet section. Next, we'll play for you a piece by Dmitri Shostakovich's suite for Variety Orchestra. Waltz No. 2 is one of the composer's most recognizable tunes. The suite was composed post-1956 and was subsequently used as a part of the soundtrack for the Russian film The First Electron. As you listen, if you close your eyes, you may get transported to the ballroom in the 1800s. If you do, we'll know we did our job. This piece will feature a solo for grade 11, also saxophonist Paige Thompson. Please enjoy our rendition of Shostakovich's Waltz No. 2.
Thank you.
Ollie Joel McDonald in the front row, everybody. You're the best, Ollie. Hello. My name is Brennan Smith. I am obviously a member of the band and a member of lots of musical ensembles in Tosh. Baba Yetu is a Swahili setting of the Lord's Prayer, originally commissioned as the theme song for the video game Civilization IV. Since its debut in 2005, it's become an immensely popular choral work and one of the most critically acclaimed pieces of music written for a video game, winning a Grammy Award in 2011 for Best Instrumental Arrangement Accompanying Vocalists. It features primary solos from Euden Ledwell Cox and Kira McDougall. You will also hear some smaller solos from Leah Heffel on alto, Stephanie Stewart on flute, and Henry McGinnis on trumpet. We hope you enjoy, and thank you.
Hello. My name is Lily Hall, and I play the tuba. I'm in grade 12. The title track of our concert this evening, Dawn of a New Day, is conceived as a descriptive work that depicts the composer's thoughts of a typical workday in an urban setting. The opening fanfare paints a musical portrait of magnificent sunrise that is best described as being both stunning and radiant. What follows is a series of mood changes typical of the ups and downs we experience in a day. As the title, Dawn of a New Day, suggests, this is a celebration of what we've accomplished as a group this year and what lies ahead in our future. This piece features a piccolo and muted trumpet duet from Salem Austin and Daisy Stewart. As well as a flute solo from a grade 10 flautist, Adiela Rice.
Flautist.
This is Dawn of a New Day, and our title track of the evening, we hope you enjoy.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone. My name is Ella Ramsey. I'm in grade 12, and I am a tenor saxophonist in the band and also in the R&B band. Our next title is called Where Words End. Sometimes music is not about anything. It exists solely for the beautiful sounds it creates and the emotions derived from that aesthetic experience. Where Words End falls firmly into this category of music. The title comes from a famous quote, "Where words end, music begins." Music can express emotions, ideas, pictures, and states of grace that no words or pictures could ever hope to capture. That is what makes music special. This is truly an amazing piece, and I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Okay, back on the mic. Hope you guys are enjoying your evening so far. For those of you who have been around the band program longer than me, longer than September, you'll notice that there's a brains behind this operation that I didn't start. This band was really, really good before I even got here, and it's all to do with Mrs. Bryson. Miss Bryson's the brains behind the operation. She's been here many, many years. She graciously handed over the program. She likes to joke with me that she doesn't like to share, so it's a good thing I'm here, because she trusted me. and so I thought, like, going into this, she's put, like, her heart and soul into this program, and I thought it would be, like, very, very fitting to have her conduct a piece, especially for our graduating students who have been with her for 2 years, for the 11s who had her last year, and also as professional development for me, because then I get to watch and play. So I'm gonna get to play in this. There's gonna be a student introduce this piece, but I'm gonna introduce the amazing Mrs. Bryson to the podium.
Saxophone in the band as well as the R&B band, and I'm introducing Arabian Dances. Arabian Dances features Middle Eastern sounds that combine authentic traditional melodies and rhythms with original music. After a haunting opening, authentic Middle Eastern percussion instruments create the groove that accompanies the folk song Ala Dalona, which you will first hear as a piccolo solo from our flute section leader Salem Austin. As the orchestration builds, original themes are intertwined before the percussion section becomes the focus of the third section. The final melody, Tafta Hindi, develops until it morphs into an ostinato over a magnificent presentation of the original theme that is found throughout the work.
Thank you. How about that, Mr. Kelly on the bongos? The secret is that we have a second music teacher, so each of us gets to play a little bit. Okay, I won't take long, but I just have to say thank you. I know Mr. Kelly probably has lots of thank yous to all the people that we both would normally thank during a concert, so I will save those for him. But I have to thank, first of all, the music students from me. It's been so, obviously, so beautiful to get to spend this last concert with you and to get to do a piece with you, which was Mr. Kelly's idea, and so beautiful and nice of him to think of that. And so thank you so much, of course. And we'll spend more time together, so this is just a thank you for now. And I really don't like to share, that is the truth. And I said that to Mr. Kelly, recovery control freak, but learning to let go. And seeing, like, good news, our music program is doing so well, and it's thriving, and it's exploding. And so, good news to have to need help, and you need to know how to ask for help, right? Sometimes, we need the lesson we need to learn. And I happen to know an absolutely incredible music educator who I said one day, hey, how far do you drive to Morrell? And it's like, would you drive the other distance? You better apply for this job. And thankfully, it worked out. And so I just want to thank Mr. Kelly for just being such an incredible human and a wonderful music educator, and for being like such a trustworthy partner to run this crazy music world with. Thank you.
Have two pieces left, and I'm sorry if you thought I was winded after Age of Chivalry. I've had many bruises on the hands from that piece. Today we recognize 15 individuals that have poured their heart and soul into this program over the past 3 years. They've devoted 6 years of their life to band, and I can say that they've become better people because of it, me. I've certainly been lucky to know them and work with them, and I wanted to acknowledge them tonight because they're going, all 15 of them are going to post-secondary school next year. Yeah. Hold your applause to the end, but I think they deserve an individual shout out. Connor Arsenault, stand up. He's going to Holland College for woodworking. Lily Hall, stand up. She's going to Acadia for engineering. We have Emma Sarazano, stand up. She's going to UPEI for pre-vet. Stay standing. Henry McGinnis on trumpet. Henry McGinnis is going to Holland College for the SOPA program, School of Performing Arts. Brennan Smith, he's going to UPEI for music. We have Ella Ramsey, who's going to Mount A for environmental studies. Jacob Katmus, he's going to UPEI for engineering. We have Leah Heffel. I see you, Tamara, I'm coming back. Leah Heffel's going to UPEI for psychology. Tamara Heffel, she's been training me on this one. She's going to l'Institut de Jean Raymond for hairdressing. We have Brianna Steele is going to UPEI for nursing. We have Ayessa Davina, UPEI political science. We have Stephanie Stewart, she's going to UNB for health science. We have her twin sister Felicia, other set of twins, sorry, I forgot the twins. Felicia's also going to UNB, but she's going to nursing. And Hayden Gallant is going to UPEI for graphic design, and right to my left, Salem Austin, Mount A, physics. Give a round of applause for our graduates. Miss you guys so much. We wish you all the best in your future. Don't be strangers. Come on back and visit us at Tosh, okay?
Hayden!
Thank you.
Yeah.
Who? Where? Did I miss someone? What did I say? Oh, sorry. I knew that. Hayden's, there's so many of them going UPI. I knew that, too. I'm surprised I only messed up one, to be honest. Hayden Lang is going to Holland College for graphic design. UPI doesn't have a graphic design program. It does? So. Okay. Holland College is going to love you, Hayden. Okay, Yudin. Sorry, we have an introduction. There's so much things to say. We're going to play this piece. I'll let Yudin introduce it, but we're going to dedicate it to our grade 12s.
See You Again is a song by American rapper and singer Wiz Khalifa, featuring fellow American singer-songwriter Charlie Puth. It was commissioned for the soundtrack of the 2015 film Furious 7, and broke many streaming records, including most streams ever in a day on Spotify, and most views on YouTube until 2017. We are playing this song as a tribute to our beloved grade 12 students, who will be leaving us and going on to bigger and better things upon graduation. We will miss you all, and hopefully our paths will cross again. This is See You Again.
So many people to thank. It's the last song. I was having a fight with, not a fight, we were having a discussion over what piece to end with tonight. Some of them wanted to end with See You Again. Others wanted to end with a big bang. So we're going to end with the big bang, which is the piece at the end of the program. We have a few thank yous to give out. Of course, we're in this like beautiful venue, and I think we're extremely, extremely lucky to be here. You guys get fantastic sight lines. We get fantastic sound and lighting. So we got to thank Peter Glenn and the crew in the middle. We're also very thankful here at Tosh that we have a very, very supportive administration, and they're here this evening. Where are they? Jacqueline Reeves and Claire Casey Smith, I think, are there. They're very, very supportive of us. They say yes to almost everything, and we're very, very grateful for them, because I think without them supporting Miss Bryson's wishes, I wouldn't be here. I wouldn't be here. So I have them to thank for being here, so thank you. We have a fantastic Band Parents Association. They take care of all the fundraising for the trips that we do. I think I said this in the last concert, my last school. We didn't have a Band Parents Association. It was just me doing all the fundraising in addition to what I do on a daily basis. It's a lot of work. And so Jonathan Sharp and the Band Parents Association, I can't see you, Jonathan, but there you go. You saw him in him and Janet at the front taking tickets. They went on the band trip with us, and they do so much for us. Amanda McLean is not here today, I don't think, also does a lot of work for us financially. So thank you to you guys and the Band Parents. Almost done. In addition to administration support, band parents support, colleagues support, we need the support of parents. You guys are the ones that fuel the fire that is the students. You guys drive them, a lot of them, to early morning band practice despite your busy schedules. I'm a father of a 4-year-old and a 2-year-old. They're actually here in the audience. Emma and Tommy, are you there? Or do they fall asleep? Oh. Hey, Emma. They are busy enough, but like I'm also imagining the life of teenagers and just the schedules that they go on. So I'm very appreciative of you. I'm going to be in your shoes someday. And so thank you from the bottom of my heart. Yeah, Mom, yeah, Dad. And finally, I gave them a big, big thank you this morning. And I gave the grade 12s a thank you. My students, I hope you know how much you mean to me. It's been a pleasure. We still got a few weeks left to hang and to play. And we got a big show or two coming up. June 6th and 7th, they're huge shows. They actually sell out, both of them, usually. So I'm sure some of you have tickets to that, or will be getting tickets. I think they're not available yet. I think they're available right now. Yeah, right now. So get your tickets to the big show, June 6th and 7th. But back to my thank you to the students. You guys are awesome. You make my job the best job in the world. Thank you. Man, I said we'd be done at 8, and I think we're gonna be done at 8. It's crazy. Oh, I'm good. All right, who's yes. Thanks everyone for coming.
Hello. I'm Henry McGinnis. I'm a grade 12. I play the trumpet. I'm in this band, the Tosh Wind Ensemble, and the school's R&B band, which you can see at the big show June 6th and 7th. Get your tickets now. The next piece is going to be recognizable to a lot of you. If you know the name Alan Silvestri, which you should if you've ever sat through the credits of a Marvel movie to see a random post-credit scene, you should know it because you should have been paying attention. You could have missed something. He's written so many iconic pieces in his lifetime, Back to the Future, Forrest Gump, Polar Express, among many others, and I think this is probably one of his most iconic pieces of work. Michael Brown's arrangement is able to capture the excitement and emotional roller coaster that Silvestri intended. Suspenseful and haunting, emotional and reflective, epic and magnificent. All feelings that you may experience during this work. We hope that you enjoy this arrangement of Silvestri's work from Avengers Endgame. That was supposed to get an applause, but it didn't. Our final selection for this evening. Have a great night, everyone.
me for an hour. Thank you. next one.